Okay, well now I am so excited because we're here with a star of stage, screen, and television that I've always admired and always wanted to meet and talk to and have on the Stephen Holt Show, and he's got a big hit movie opening right now that's going to be the sensation of the year as far as I'm concerned. Gun Hill Road, and it's Esai Morales. Hola.
Hey, hi, Stephen.
Yes. I'm this huge fan of yours, and I love the movie.
Thank you. Thank you for the love, number one, and number two, for the movie, because isn't it a special film? It's different.
It's, well, I know Rashad since, for 10 years, wow, since he was an actor. And I saw all his performances at NYU grad act. He's a very talented actor, you
I'm
know.
Sure.
He's... I saw him do Brick in Cat in the Tin Roof.
Okay.
And then I sort of lost track of him, but he wasn't far. He was in NYU film school then. And
learning.
This is
learning a lot.
And this is his thesis project, Gun Hill Road. It's so good. It's so strong. It's so powerful. And it's an indie, the lowest budget imaginable.
Yeah, I thought the budget was what my salary was going to be. I was like, oh, good. They're going to pay me. They go, no, that's the movie's budget, not your budget. I'm like, okay. And it just kind of saddened me because the reality is that our stories get no budget.
I mean, stories about Latinos and Hispanics.
Yeah, about, like, our dramas. I mean, look, if you want to do Chasing Poppy or some sort of, like, campy, you know, coochie-coochie, you know, hot tamales type of thing, there might be a little more. But to tell honest, heartfelt stories, to help artists like Rashad develop, they're very, very little money.
But your presence, I'm sure, in this film generated...
It helped.
But well, good for you, Esai, for doing this difficult subject.
It's a tough subject for most mainstream. I just became a parent myself. Actually, I left my gal at home 7 months pregnant to go do this movie for no money.
In the Bronx.
Yeah.
Was she far? Maybe she was in Brooklyn?
She was in L.A.
Oh, she was in L.A., okay.
Yeah, but you know what? She said to me, she goes, if you really, really believe this is a special project, and if you could live with yourself not being here during what might be your only child's birth, you go right ahead. I'm like, well, thanks a lot. That was like a mixed blessing in a sense, but I was really, you know, it was a sacrifice. It was well worth it, because if you see this film, I think you'll get it. It has the power to help heal families, I believe, that have been torn asunder because of one or both parents' inability to deal with the reality
of
their child's
sexual identity. I have to tell you now
that
I'm from the Bronx. I was going to have a sex change. This is the story of my family, and yes, that happened.
Were you really going to have a sex change?
Yes, I was. I went into that with Harmony in great detail. I knew Andy Warhol, and I was involved. They've heard this story before.
Wow.
My mother would, you know, I'm from Parkchester. So I'm from not far in the Bronx, from Gun Hill Road, and I remember my mother shopping with me for pantyhose. I never told the story at Macy's. This was her contribution. She was getting a clue. That's what I wanted, you know.
Well, it's so funny, because I asked my gal before I found out if it was a girl or a boy. I go, honey, what would you do if our son was gay? She's from a farm family, you know, in Brazil, kind of conservative. She thought about it. She goes, take him shopping.
Yeah, that's what my mother did.
Hello. Yes. The point is, go with the flow. I mean, you can sit here and try to, you know, push Mother Nature back in some sort of weird closet it doesn't belong into. But when you realize that your three-year-old boy looks in the mirror and sees a little girl and says so, you should pay attention. You need to respect even a child's identity. And they know, people know when they're early on, you know, they're attracted to people of their own sex, or they want to dress up more. I mean, who didn't walk around in mom's or dad's shoes and clothes, okay? And I'm sure it must have been pretty sight which inspired you. Maybe I should take this all the way. But why didn't you? Why didn't you go through?
Assuming you didn't. Well, this is me after the sex change.
Oh.
This is how I came out. But anyway,
okay.
I got to a point, and I talked about this in Harmony's interview, where being with Jackie Curtis, and I was living in as a woman at that point, and she was, of course, the famous Warhol transvestite superstar, and I said, I'm going to do it. I'm right there now. I'm ready to take the horn. And she said, don't do it. Don't do it. I've told this story before.
Really?
In other words, what she was trying to say was, it's okay for me, but it's not okay for you. And you should find your own path as an overweight flaming faggot, which is...
So you're in the Q section of LGBTQ now.
I think I'm in the...
No, but at that point you were Q, meaning questioning.
Questioning,
I found out what Q, I thought Q was, you know, queer or quasar or, you know, querical.
They just added that Q on just to confuse even me.
Yes.
As if I wasn't confused enough about gender issues, but anyway.
I don't think you're confused.
No, not anymore. No, I know I'm gay. I come to that conclusion. And one of the things that I really was one of the most enjoyable cinema experiences I've ever had along that night was seeing you in Rapa Nui. Well, all of you practically.
In my
thong?
Tooth floss thong, yeah, that was fun.
I always wondered what if I'd ever get to talk to the actors who were wearing that thing in Rent Rapa Nui, by the way, after you've seen Gun Hill Road.
Naughty, naughty.
What was it like running around Easter Island?
Terrible, because Jason Scott Lee had an incredibly aquiline, like, you know, what do you call it? Aquaman body. I mean, incredibly cut from the Kung Fu movies and the Surfer. And I felt like a potato head with my love handles.
Just fine.
But I had some, you know, we did some exercise to keep the muscles on. And I was the Che Guevara of Easter Island.
Yeah.
But now I'm more like the daddy, daddy please don't.
Yeah, the bad daddy. And
the baddie.
Yeah, you're the sort of villain, but yet we understand you.
That's my specialty, to bring a sort of pathos to these characters that you would just hate.
Yeah.
But I think I try to bring a dimension that makes you go, well, hang on a minute. I see that he has a perspective. I mean, my character isn't just bad for the sake of bad.
He's just getting out of jail at the beginning of the movie.
Yeah, and in jail there's a hierarchy. And if you're ladylike at all, you're not at the top of the totem pole. You're smoking pole and taking pole. And for my character, that was the antithesis of what he expected to find. And what he expected to
see. In jail? He was surprised by this?
After coming home.
Oh.
From that mentality, jail is extremely rigid. It's like, you know, like an authoritarian, you know, very hierarchical.
Right.
And, you know, you're either a pitcher or a catcher. Even in jail, there's that hierarchy. I did not want my son to suffer what I've seen other people suffer in prison, you know? I was victimized. And we don't go into detail.
No.
My character.
No.
In the
but
story.
We know it's there.
It's there, and you see my reaction to it when I catch the guy outside. And, you know, it's just... The thing about this movie that I really like, that in spite of the little money we had, Rashad learned enough to layer the performances
and
not try to tell the story with every scene.
Well, he's a great actor himself, so that's what... And as are you, and it was just so thrilling with Judy Reyes, who when she came in to be interviewed with me last week, I didn't even recognize her. She's so young and cute and beautiful.
She just had a baby too.
Oh my God! I know, she was talking about that and how she was just great and a wonderful performance. I mean, it's and to come home and find that your son is trying to turn into your daughter, and your character, of course, can't accept it and is freaking out.
And he's not sophisticated. He's not like, you know, he grew up on the village where, hey, everybody has a cousin or a friend that they accept. He thinks it is a slap in the face.
To his masculinity,
to his manhood and to God.
Yes, and my father felt the same way,
It's a slap in the face to God. And I asked the real character, this was inspired by a real story, what was your motivating, what was eating at you? What made you do the things that you did? And he thought about it and goes, well, I just felt God don't make mistakes. And that's what these, you know, poor souls who are kind of caught in the game of chairs of sexuality, of identity, gender, you know, gender identity, they're in between and they're looked at as mistakes.
I know. Oh, believe me. And I've lived every moment of this movie myself in my own life.
Okay, so then you understand.
And being from the Bronx. Oh my God.
Wow.
Irish Catholic. Latino Catholic. Same thing.
But it's like, you know, when people are like, oh, a TG movie. I go, no. It's not about TG. It uses this wonderful transgender actress, Harmony, who's just become an actress.
And that profile in the New York Times, God.
But to embody...
Hello, Oscar. Hello.
To embody a more pure vision of this situation, which we usually see in camp. You know, I love Priscilla, Queen of the Desert as much as anybody.
Yeah.
But those are straight actors showing off their chops.
Yeah.
This is real deal.
Yes.
I mean, how many opportunities do transgender actors have?
Well, that's why I became a talk show host. Or host and hostess. Because
yes.
That's... where, you know.
The host with the mostest.
Oh, thank you, Esai. You're now my favorite movie star of all time. Anyway, I, and of course you're an incredibly experienced and versatile actor, as Judy is as an actress.
I'm glad you said actor. I thought you said experienced.
Oh,
he read the file.
Yes, I did. But anyway, we won't go there. But here you are working with basically Harmony Santana, who's a non-actor. And the two of you are so experienced, and Harmony is just, this is the first thing she's ever done.
Which is, but it's a good thing, because
it worked out just fine for you. Yeah, Harmony it wasn't
was
a
able,
problem.
Not yeah. really. I mean, look, there were times where we wondered, you know, is Harmony going to be able to bring it on the day?
Right, right.
When the cameras roll, there's another, you know, adrenaline boost that happens.
Right.
The big as if becomes much more internalized.
Right.
You know, we live these moments as if they were true, as if they were happening now for the first time. And, you know, Judy is a consummate act professional.
She is, yes,
she
absolutely.
She has her comedy chops, but not everybody knows her dramatic skills.
Well, after this movie, they will.
They sure will. And I've been around forever. And I think
you've been around, you're a kid.
We're
Excuse
pillars.
Me.
No surgery, no nothing.
I founded homosexuality.
Oh, really?
Shortly
did?
After World War II. Yes,
I did. You founded homosexuality?
Yeah, I started.
And where did you put it after that?
I just...
That's very funny. Like, I liked that he drew in that movie. I founded it, homosexuality.
Yeah, yeah, and it caught on, and the kids were buying it up and buying it up like crazy.
Yeah.
So anyway, Gun Hill Road, once again, it's the indie hit film of the year. What is always a film that emerges, and this is the film that's emerging this year. It's playing, Mihal, it's playing at the Angelica.
Great
and
theater.
At the AMC. I mean, it's getting distributed.
AMC have given us the best theaters in New York for our New York Open, which has
how
to be
that,
important.
How did that happen?
Mike Thomas, our you know, distributor, booker, I mean,
uh-huh.
he really did an amazing job. Mike Thomas called and made sure people saw the movie and understood its importance. This is not a movie for transgender people, for gay people, for Latinos, for blacks, for Bronx people. This is a universal story. It's not just about the people.
No,
that it transcends it, because really
it does.
It's about
yeah.
being accepted by your family.
Yes.
It's about being
yes.
trying to find out who you are and being honest to that.
Yes.
And who doesn't have issues with that?
Yes. Yes. And I have to say one more shout out to Rashad Ernesto Green. How did this script come to you? This is my last question. How did the script come to you when you and all of this?
Well, you
happened?
Founded Homosexuality.
Yeah.
I founded, along with Jimmy Smits and Sonia Braga, an organization called the National Hispanic Foundation for the Arts. And we are out of
I
DC.
Did not know that.
Yes. Well, Rashad was a 3-time recipient of our scholarship when he was going to NYU Film School.
Oh,
and
now? I just thought he was rich, you
yeah.
know.
No. And
how
he,
fabulous
he
is that?
He comes up to me and he says, listen, I got the script. It's almost ready. I just want to tell you about it. I'm going to go through the proper channels, which I really respect, because, you know, through Facebook and social media. And read my script. I'd love to help, but let's go through the proper channels so we can filter it and really pay attention to it. And I read this script and I was like, really? Wow. And then I said, you know, I don't care that there's not a lot of money. There's a lot of heart. And a lot of movies today, I mean, I don't want to name names, but, you know, big CGI spectacles. No,
I don't even go to them.
I can't.
It's like
you
have to be
a video
robot.
Game.
I know.
Yeah.
I can't do it.
I want a joystick if I'm going to see those games.
I only usually do Oscar coverage. So, of course, I think that this film is going to... This
Listen.
Film has the potential of breaking through, like Winter's Bone did. Like
that's a good one. Precious, we hope.
Or Julianne Moore and Annette Bening and
oh
was,
yes, the kids are
kids
all
are
right.
all right. Yeah, hello. Yeah, two best picture nominees. Yeah, this film is going to have a very very ferocious group of admirers. Hopefully in the Academy. Hello, are you listening? And listen, if they can nominate Jay Davidson for best supporting actor, they can certainly nominate everybody in this film.
Oh, you're so sweet.
Oscar is listening. I'm listening.
Your mouth to Oscar well, God's ears.
Well, you know, that they listen to me. Because I don't say it lightly, because otherwise, you know,
I have a
no
friend that I showed this film to, and he was like, well, no, Precious is a whole other animal. I said, well, I think it could strike a chord the way Precious is. Oh, no, he said, this movie will have a limit. And I thought he was poo-pooing it a little too prematurely.
Well, look what happened to that film.
That's right. But listen to this. I believe, and I challenge people to go out there and see a movie with not a lot of explosions, but a lot of dynamics. It's really about the human condition from a different perspective.
It certainly is, and I thank you so much, Esai Morales,
thank
here
you,
today,
Steven.
For popping in at the Bombay Palace Restaurant, and yeah.
wait, do we do the?
Yeah, no, we're here.